Hello guys, and welcome back for another video. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how you know that you're fat adapted without doing tests and the benefits of being fat adapted. So stay tuned for that. So if you're new to this channel, I would love to have you subscribe by clicking the button that is here. We discuss the ketogenic diet, family subjects, and electric cars on this channel. So please make sure you hit that button so you don't miss any of the videos that are coming out. So I'm gonna tell you about my personal experience of being on the ketogenic diet for almost 3 months now, and what actually it means to be fat adapted or keto adapted, as opposed to just being in ketosis. So ketosis is a scientifically defined term, which is a certain level of ketones in your blood level that you can test, and I'm not going to go into the science of this, but basically light ketosis can occur even if you fast for 12 to 16 hours, meaning if you had dinner, you go to sleep, and you miss your breakfast, then you will be in some very light form of ketosis, but it doesn't at all mean that you are fat adapted. So fat adaptation happens when you have been on the ketogenic diet for quite a long period of time, and your body starts to prefer fat for its fuel, and you can go back to eating carbs, but your body for like a meal or cheat a little bit, and your body will very fast go back to being in ketosis again because you're fat adapted. So this comes with a lot of time being on the ketogenic diet and certain signs that I'm going to cover in this video. So there is a lot of misconceptions about what it means to be fat adapted and a lot of data, and this is mostly because there isn't a scientific definition of what it means to be fat adapted, so it's not a very easily definable thing, and that the longer you have been on a ketogenic diet, actually the more benefits you will gain, and the more easily your body will start to handle and burn fat, and simply the more adapted you will be. I mean, think about it. You have been, most probably, if you are new to the ketogenic diet, on a sugar burning or glucose burning diet for all your life, and to change from that drastically to a whole new metabolic system in your body, obviously it's not gonna go in a day, it's not gonna go in a week, and it's not gonna go in 3 weeks, and your body just keeps on adjusting and being better at it, and like the benefits will increase. I think that to fully adapt to keto, I read somewhere that it can even take up to 6 months and you will just see increased benefits. So it's a long period of time, and as I said in earlier videos, keto is a lifestyle change and it's not a side diet change, and you have to be in it for the long run. You cannot just do it like for 2 days trying out what keto is like, because you will simply not experience any of the benefits that come with being on a ketogenic diet. So here are the symptoms that you're going to experience when you start to be fat adapted. So the first one of them is having increased focus in your brain and having a better memory. And this is very simple to explain, because there's two ways your brain can get energy. One of them is through glucose, and the other one is through ketones when you're on ketosis. And the ketones simply can carry more oxygen per unit, so your brain actually gets a lot more oxygen, so it can operate clearly. So it's very logical that when you're in ketosis or fat adapted, that you're a lot more aware in your mind and your memory improves, and that's a very good thing. So number two is that you will experience better energy levels. So what happens when you're in glucose burning mode is that when you eat carbs, they get burned up really fast, and then you still have your body fat left, but because your body is not adapted to burning your own body fat for fuel, it will start to just crave more carbs. So that's why when you're on a carb diet, you will feel this never being full, never satiated, and always being hungry, because you just eat the food, it gets burnt up, gone, and then your body is not using your own body fat, it will just want to have more carbs. So when you're keto adapted, you will feel that you have higher levels of energy, you can very simply skip meals and you will not notice it, you will not be hangry, you will not be emotional when you miss meals, and also you will be a lot more consistent. So if you're doing heavy physical work or workout, you will get less tired and you will feel that your body just has more energy and it takes a lot more to burn you out, and it's generally a very good feeling. So number three, that is the non-existence of carb cravings. So from my experience, I have been a very big sugar eater and I have been very heavy on sweets. I was a very big sweet tooth. And basically, even though that I was on a ketogenic diet, or I've been on the ketogenic diet for 2 months, I still had sugar cravings. And only now in the recent weeks have I noticed that when I think of eating chocolates on Christmas, I get this like, ugh, I really don't desire it, I really don't want it. And it used to be in the beginning of my ketogenic diet, when I was buying food and, you know, you go to the kassa in the store to pay and they have all these sweets, and it was really hard for me to not put things from there in my basket and just snack on them. And this one, as I told you in the beginning of the video, that the ketogenic diet, like, you very gradiently get adjusted to burning fat. So for me, it took 3 months for the sugar cravings to almost completely go away. I still have a little bit, but like, I almost get disgusted now from the thought of eating a Snickers bar and cheating on a diet. And it's a very, very big difference for me and a very good feeling. So number four, as a sign of you being keto adapted, is that your appetite goes down a lot. So as I said before, when you're on a carb diet, and specifically when I was on a carb diet, I felt I was never satiated. I was always hungry. If I didn't control my eating, I could technically just go on eating nonstop in a day, which is pretty sick, very unhealthy. And now on the ketogenic diet, I eat actually 2 times per day, and it's very easy for me to keep this. It's just a very good feeling that when I eat, I'm actually full and I cannot eat more, and it lasts for hours and hours, and I don't think about eating all the time. I'm very thankful for this, and that's actually a very good benefit for me. My fifth sign of your keto adapted would have to be that the body actually starts preferring the fatty foods and preferring the ketogenic diet. So I was just on a quick road trip somewhere, and the only thing that was offered there as food was carbs, and I was eating it like, okay, I have to eat this. And immediately after I ate it, I was thinking about, okay, I will go home and have my keto meals. And basically it feels like my body is actually preferring and needing fat, and when I'm hungry or craving something, it's more that I'm craving the ketogenic food. And obviously this makes it so it's very easy with time to follow the ketogenic diet. So it has, in the beginning when you start for the first, I would say 1 to 3 weeks, it can be an effort, especially in the first week, a lot of willpower to stay on this diet. But now after 3 months, it has turned into the opposite. It would require willpower for me to go off this diet, because my body is just so used to burning fat that that's what it craves. So that's all the signs that you know that you're keto adapted. Again, I wanna bring attention to the fact that it happens on a gradient. So maybe in the first week, what you will notice is that your head becomes clearer. You start feeling this increased energy. That's what happened to me. But I had carb cravings up to 2.5 months on being on the ketogenic diet. Then now, like after almost 3 months, it started with the body actually preferring the fatty foods, and like I feel like the energy level of the body somehow increases bit by bit, and it's becoming easier and easier to keep the ketogenic diet. I feel more and more satisfied after eating. So as I said, it's a long process. If you're trying the ketogenic diet, then very, very good, and keep doing it. The benefits are awesome and you will not regret it. You will thank yourself later. So I really hope that this video helped you if you're beginning on the ketogenic diet. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions that you want to ask me about the ketogenic diet. Thank you very much for watching, and make sure you check out our website here. We have more tips and recipes and ketogenic meal plans. And I will see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao.